I'm Milan Saint-Hilaire, and in this video, we're going to talk about advanced customization of Mesh Central's website. So Mesh Central has ways of customizing the website through the config.json file. And that's great for basic things, and we're going to review that. But if you want to do any advanced configuration or customization of Mesh Central, like changing style sheets, changing images, or changing the website itself, there's a proper way to do that, and we're going to take a look at that today. So I'm going to start with my trusty developer server right here, and it's running on port 80 and 443, and I have the website open right there, so I can click on a device and, of course, connect to it and see the remote desktop and so on. So this all works perfectly fine. Now, the first thing I want to show and or recap is that we can change the customization of a few things from the config.json file. So I have, for example, here the title is set to Mesh Central on the default domain. I can set it to Bob, and I can set the title to, this is the upper right string, I can put it to Joe, and I can restart the server, run it again, and here I'm logged in always as user because I do dash dash user and min, and so I don't see the login screen. And then you can see Bob and Joe right there. And you can also see that Bob, the title, is on the title on the top of the title bar for the browser. So that's great. You can also customize, you can put an image right here if you want to. You can change the images on the login screen. You can put a background on the login screen. So there's lots of things you can do to do customization. But let's suppose I want to change like the images on the left side here, or I want to change like, you know, the color, or, you know, like something much more radical. Now, what you could do is you can go inside the directory structure of Mesh Central. And I'm going to apologize here because this is my developer machine, so the structure is a little different on your machine than mine. But normally you would see node modules, and then inside node modules you would see Mesh Central. So I have the Mesh Central folder right here, but anyway. So you would go in node modules, Mesh Central, and you would see a folder called public. And in here would be images, and there would be scripts, and there would be styles, and even sounds. Those are the main HTML elements that are loaded through for the web server that are served. There's also the favorite icons here. And lastly, the main web pages are inside views. So things like the default handlebar, that's the main website that controls, you know, all the remote desktop and everything. There's also the login page, but also messages and the remote player and so on and so forth. Okay, so one thing you could be tempted to do is to just go inside node modules, Mesh Central, go inside, for example, views or public, and start modifying those images. Now, if you do that, the problem is as soon as you update Mesh Central, all those changes will be lost because everything under the node modules folder is going to be replaced with an update. So any change you make under node modules, Mesh Central, that's going to be wiped out as soon as you update. So that's not the right way to go. What we're going to do is we are going to go back up to the same folder that the same level as the Mesh Central data folder, and we are going to create a folder called Mesh Central web. There you go. And inside of that, we are going to create a folder called public. And we can also create another folder called views if we want to. And then inside public, we will create folders like images and so on and so forth. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to open another file explorer, and I am going to go to the same, I'm going to go to the Mesh Central folder. And in Mesh Central folder, there's a public folder. So whatever is in this public folder is going to override what's in the Mesh Central public folder. So, for example, I have a fab icon right here, And let's suppose I want to replace it with something else. So let's see, or I have, let's try, yeah, I can do fab icon. So the thing is, yeah, I'm going to go in public and I'm going to have this icon here. No, actually, that's not correct. Let me try something else. Actually, let's try just an image. So I'm going to go in public, say images. And then inside here, I'm going to scroll down and find something interesting, like the left bar. So the left bar is the images you'll see here. So I'm going to copy this onto public images. So it's the same as public images here. And I'm going to edit it. And I'm just going to put some red scribble on here. Save it. Okay. And then go back to the website and hit reload. Let's see, maybe I didn't grab this one. I'll grab the other. Oh, yeah. The other thing is I may need to restart the server here. And the reason I need to restart the server is the server needs to know that these... Oh, there it goes. So once I restarted the server figured out, there's this folder now called meshcentral-web, so I need to take that into account when I serve the pictures or whatever. So I'm going to go in meshcentral-web, public, images, and now I think I don't need to... So I'm going to take a blue marker and just do a blue line like this. I don't need to restart the server anymore. Now I have this blue line, I hit refresh, and you see the blue line show up on these icons. So now the nice thing about using meshcentral-web is that that folder replaces the default ones inside the node modules folders, but when you update, these changes will stay. So that's really, really good. Now, obviously, if you update meshcentral a lot, there could be some changes that break some things. But in general, if you have a picture here of the left bar, for example, and you change it, most of the time you'll just update meshcentral, and nothing will break, and so your picture will correct. So another one is, for example, these pictures, the pictures of the devices. So I can probably find this here in the pictures. So usually it's a strip like this. For efficiency's sake, there he goes. So for efficiency's sake, the icons are just one image. And so the browser will load a single image of all these devices. So I'm just going to put a red bar here. Save. And I'm not sure if I'm doing it on the right one here, but let's try. Because there's different sizes, and there you go. So the red bar just showed up on all of them. And so here, icons 50 was used to display these. Now, you'll see that there's strips with icons, for example, 100. And the reason why there's a 15 and 100 is that on Retina display or high DPI displays, then the 100, the high resolution icons will be used. But on lower or normal displays, then the 50 will be used. And so that goes on for a lot of these icons. There's very often two copies, and depending on the screen DPI, you get the higher resolution icon or not. So for example, the battery here, for the battery state, then you have the 24 and the 48 and so on. But that's it, fairly simple. I want to do a demonstration of, let's see, obviously you can do this for scripts too. You can do this for code. So if you want to go and modify your and create your own copy of some code here, you can do that, put it in the meshcentral web folder, and that file will be served instead. Now, the last thing I want to show is views. So views here, this is the, for example, default.handlebar. This is the main web page for meshcentral. So I'm going to copy it over here, then I'm going to go in Visual Studio, drag and drop it, and I can make a change that I want. So for example, I'm going to search for a title. Let's see if I can, oops. So if I can do that, quick find, title, there it goes. So this, the title and title two here are right there. And I can replace, for example, I can change the color, for example, style, and I can put color red. And then let's see if this works. There you go, you have the red color right there. So now what I did is I made a change to the web page of Mesh Central and stuck that web page inside the views folder. Now, obviously, this is a little bit more treacherous, or because when you update Mesh Central, very often the main web page here, this code will change quite a bit. And so now you're getting, you're not advancing as you update Mesh Central. This copy, your own copy, will be used instead of the official updated one. So you want to be selective in what you update, but it's pretty good. And for advanced customization, for people who know what they're doing, this is a great technique to personalize Mesh Central. If you have an organization with very, you know, color schemes or different looks, and you want to apply your own look, this is a great way to do it. Hope that was useful. Thank you very much. Have a great day.